I don't know, Chulo, let's we keep it very confidential. Someone out of this audience had messaged me last night at around 1 o'clock, I don't know. Somewhere around 12:30, I just came back from my ICU rounds and all that. And so I was actually inspired by that message you sent, because it was a very long message and it was actually a very sad story. It's very disheartening if something like that happens to someone. Someone losing a family member and then still passing through their entrance. So first of all, whosoever that person is, really sorry for your loss. But now we get back to the sense of the message which I got from that person. Because after reading that entire message and series of so many messages which I have gotten over last 8 years after I passed the entrance, the common sense which is very, very unique to all those messages is that there is a tendency of being lost. And if someone of you feel that during the process of preparation they feel lost, first of all, it is completely normal. It happens to almost everyone. I hardly know people who didn't pass through that phase where they were not lost. And it's just not restricted to preparations, because it is restricted to basic phases of life, whether you will be in your MBBS or will be post-MBBS, or it will come to your marriage, it will come to your mid-30s. There will come phases where you will feel lost. And the reason for feeling lost is one malignant inception. According to me, the most malignant inception. You understand Inception? There's a movie based on this, okay, by Christopher Nolan. The Inception. Inception is, it's like an idea. It's like an implant. It's like a seed in your mind. So according to me, the most malignant and powerful inception which can affect any human being in life, which can lead to either a positive or a negative result, both, is about anything, and a question called it, is it worth it? When you ask yourself regarding any individual, any relationship, any entrance exam, any branch you are pursuing, or any person you stay with, or your daily life, is it worth it? So that is the exact situation where people land up, disillusioned and being lost. So actually, this picture is from a book by James Norbury, and this book was gifted to one by Zainab's student in the last BTR in Delhi. And that person written this book is dedicated to Zara, and from a frontliner sitting in Siri Fort in Delhi BTR. So I took this and I read this entire book on that one day, because Zara, I know, but she had written that once Zara will grow up, she will perhaps need this book. And it is a beautiful book of a tiny dragon and a giant panda by James Norbury. And I read the entire book in that one day. And that's why, as dedication to that student who gifted us with that book, I kept this, because this is relevant to most. That we are lost again. This will happen to you again and again. And when the tiny dragon asks, when I'm lost, how do I get back on track? You first need to understand why at the first place you thought it was worth it. When you start anything, whether you start your preparation, you start any type of work, you start building something, you always have a perception or an idea why you wanted that particular thing in your life. Slowly and slowly that idea, because repetitive struggle, hustle, trauma, mental or physical, it withers off. It completely withers off. And you get into a state where you keep asking yourself again and again, is it worth it? So I expect that there might be students who on their days of preparation feel that, should we do so much hard work? Okay, we keep on saying to people that you should work hard, you heard, huh? But it's very human to ask a question whether it is worth it or not. So now the answer to this is very individualized. And I'll not be very dogmatic in saying that one particular thing or one particular person or one particular exam can be worth it to everyone equally. It cannot be. We are different human beings. We have different expectations from us in life. We have different interests. We have different skill sets. But I feel if anyone who is preparing for this exam, if this malignant proposition that is it worth it, it will stick to you for too long. It will never let you work hard enough for it. It will always generate a sense of incompleteness, a void in you, that you will never be able to work to your best potential. So if you don't think that it's worth it, the problem is people actually in real life are not brave enough. They think that something is not worth it, still they pursue it. It happens to everyone, right? Because you don't know when this thing will not be there, what will be the outcome. So you pursue it for the sake of it. So you think it's not worth it. The moment you ask yourself this question, is it worth it? The answer is already no. Because that's the reason you ask this question to yourself. Is it worth it? So with that attitude in mind, the result can never be that great. It will never be because you have already questioned the choice you have made. But sometimes it's important also because you are destined for an alternative path. That's okay. But what I want from people is to take an all or null call on this. Asking this question, is it worth it, is fine. Not taking a decision whether it is worth it for you or not and delaying it that some magical thing in the universe will help you decide whether it is worth it for you or not will not work for you. Then you will just drag along it as the time will take you. That is why even when people take specialized branches, let us suppose someone, yesterday only when this class ended, someone had asked me that, do you think taking neurosurgery was worth it? Because we were comparing my schedule in residency to what Zainab's schedule was in residency. That Zainab used to have night duties in JR shift from 5 p.m. to 9 p.m., 4 hours. And I used to have 14 alternate day 36 hours duties for 6 years back to back. It was that hectic. I used to meet her after 36 to 48 hours. That hectic is our residency program. So the question is, had I asked that question to myself, is it worth it? I would never have become a neurosurgeon. So it will come to you. The environment will. So when you are studying very hard for an entrance exam, you might see people who are enjoying, you might see people who are relaxing, you might feel that you are the only person who is going through that grind, and few others perhaps. But again, if you do feel it's not worth it, just leave it completely. I don't have problem with that. But when you drag along with thing and still, it's just like pursuing a relationship with a person continuously and thinking at the same time he's not worth you. Because you are not sure what will happen if you don't pursue this path. But that will not even lead you to anything great in life. Anything worthwhile also. Because that cycle, that inception, that is it worth it or not. So if you get this idea, how do you get back? To get back to this, you first have to revisit why you chose that path in the first place. And that thought process or that vision can be very, very kiddish. Can be very kiddish. It's okay. It is just like a boy seeing like Zara sees a plane, and a boy sees a plane, or a girl sees a plane, and thinks, okay, I want to be a pilot. Okay? It's very, very immature. It doesn't have that much of depth. But your vision, your path, your worth, when it would have started from this small idea only. Let us suppose if some of you wanted to become a surgeon. You might have seen some surgeon operating, and you would have said, okay, this is what I want to be like 5 years from now, 10 years from now. It would have been this small an idea. At that moment, you would not have questioned whether it is worth pursuing it or not. Because you would have just chosen it on the outset. So that small memory, it might be very, very small. It is just like someone seeing a plane in the sky, just representing a freedom to fly. It just represents the freedom to fly for a child, nothing else. So you have to hold on to that individual thought. So all of you, please go back. If you have phases, that you have dilemmas, that this is not worth it, just go and reevaluate and think what made you start in the first place. It might be just, I will be very, very honest, for someone it might be just getting a rank. I have met people who just told me, sir, I don't know which branch I want. I don't know. I just know ki mujhe ye entrance clear karna hai. It's fine. Then you hold on to that thought that you standing on a podium and an entire audience clapping for you. That's fine. For someone it might be becoming an exceptionally good clinician. Okay? Like people used to see in MBBS, you have seen, might have, some of you might have seen Grey's Anatomy, House MD. Okay? Because that is fiction, na? That's fiction. That fiction inspires people. So some of you might have held that image of Grey's Anatomy in your mind. Some of you might have held the image of being a house MD in your life. Some of might you have an inspiration from your parents, from your seniors. It would be a very small idea. At that time, you didn't question it. So now, if you want to pursue it 100% and achieve anything, you will have to revisit that small clip. It's like a GIF playing again and again in your mind. Whenever you feel, is it worth it or not, you will have to replay that GIF or that small video in your mind again and again. Because unless and until you understand why you started in the first place, you will never reach the end. And trust me, if you stay long on any path in life, it might be longer than usual, it might be longer than your partner, it might be longer, you can make it worthwhile. Because the worth, the terminology of worth is actually an external concept. Everything in life and universe was made on a similar worth. But what is different between something you consider worthy and something you don't is your belief that it is worthy. So you will have to replay that belief that someday I imagined myself. Like when people ask me again and again that when you were doing your MBBS, did you have any surgical exposure to being a neurosurgeon? I say no. I just wanted to be a neurosurgeon. Uske beyond, I don't know why I wanted to be a neurosurgeon. It was like a child's dream. I just felt, okay, being neurosurgeon is like being awesome. It's fine. And honestly, every day when I used to go to AIMS in my residency, there used to be so many days, like almost every day, I used to wake up, then I used to sleep. I used to wake up, then I used to sleep. Obviously, na, my round, I have to reach by 7 o'clock in the ward. She has to get up at 11 o'clock. I'll come back home after 36 hours. She would have already had two parties, enjoyed, went to gym. I would have. So thing is, it is not you are the only person who will feel whether it is worth it or not. But I always knew that I will never be happy had I took radiology. Because obviously at rank 2, you are getting everything. And people counseled me very hard to take radiology. Like, mercilessly hard. Like, ek intern ko pakad ke log dho rahe hain. कि तू गधा है तू बेवकूफ है सेकंड रैंक पे न्यूरोसर्जन लेता है यार लोग मर रहे हैं यहां पे मेडिसिन लेने के लिए लेने के लिए तू पागल आदमी है मतलब इट डजंट सूट माय पर्सनालिटी आई विल नॉट बी हैप्पी बिकॉज़ मेरा परसेप्शन डिफरेंट है मुझे अपनी लाइफ से कुछ डिफरेंट चाहिए तुझे मतलब एवरीवन लास्ट यू तुझे पता भी है कैसे होता है न्यूरोसर्जरी तुझे पता भी है तू खड़ा भी हुआ है कभी इतने दिन अग्रीड इट्स फाइन आई वाज गिवन अ लॉट ऑफ नेगेटिव काउंसलिंग बिफोर आई वांटेड टू टेक न्यूरोसर्जरी बिकॉज़ दैट्स हाउ वर्ल्ड इज Not that they have done neurosurgery, but still, it's fine. It's your perception. It's like that, ki, matlab, mujhe laga ki mujhe, let us suppose, I like a particular girl, but tumhare char dost baith jayenge mandli bitha ke, theek hai? Char log, usme do log daru ki bottle khol ke, ki main batata hu, tujhe aisa kya hone wala hai? Tumhe khud koi experience nahi hai, but main tumhe zarur bataunga ki life mein tumhare sath kya hone wala hai. So, it's that type of guidance. So, what I want you is that, अगर आपको लाइफ में कुछ बहुत बड़ा करना है फॉर दैट यू नीड टू हैव अ चाइल्ड्स ड्रीम यू कैन नॉट किल दैट चाइल्डहुड बट फ्रॉम योर माइंड बिकॉज इफ यू मेक टू मच मैथमेटिकल यू विल एनालाइज टू मच वेदर इट इज वर्थ इट वर्थ इट वर्थ इट तो अल्टीमेटली एक्चुअली ऑनेस्टली वर्थ तो हर चीज के बराबर है. यू विल रीच अ कंक्लूजन इट्स नॉट वर्थ इट. ट्रस्ट मी यू विल रीच अ कंक्लूजन इट्स नॉट वर्थ इट बिकॉज एनीथिंग वर्थ वाइल माइट हैपन 10 years from now, 15 years from now, we don't know whether it will happen or not. There is no assurance of that. But you need to hold on to that child's dream, okay, of someone seeing a plane fly and just you thought, ki haan yaar pilot bante hai, badhiya hai, udenge. So similarly, you just hope, all of you, if you want to pursue medicine, surgery or any medical profession, and trust me, this thing I am saying, you will need more once you clear entrance. Your problem is not current. Your problem will start after this entrance. I am telling you. ये शादी की तरह है. बाद की story कोई नहीं बताता. तो मैं last line में बस ये बताऊँगा. तुम्हारी problem इसके बाद बहुत बड़ी शुरू होगी. Because इसके बाद तुम ये सवाल अपने आप से करोगे. Was it worth it? Hold on to your dream. It is just your belief which makes the difference whether it's worth it or not. It's a very, very malignant idea. It breaks the entire world down for people when you question this is worth it or not. So, for that, just hold on to that dream and replay it in your mind. So, on your days, when you feel weak, when you feel disappointed, when you feel whether I should give another attempt or not, just remember a vision. You might have had a vision. If you don't, you have it now. It might be just like me standing here. You might imagine yourself standing on this stage. You might imagine yourself doing a particular surgery. You might imagine yourself joining a particular college. That small clip, that small video clip. How many of you have watched? I think so. Harry Potter to bahut logon ne dekha hoga na. So in Harry Potter, there's something called as pensieve. The concept of a pensieve where you can revisit your memories. So you need to develop an internal pensieve where you can take a clip out and you play it again and again, again and again, again and again. Because that's the only thing which will make it worth it. Otherwise, there is no external validation system which can make you believe it's worth it. And till you play it again and again in your mind that yes, someday I'll be there in that particular situation and the world will be there to give a standing ovation for me, it will not happen. That is what is called as BTR based on belief. This is belief. This clip is belief. So this clip you have to play again and again. That will take you to the beginning, whether it is worth it or not. Okay? Thank you.